Welcome to
Celebrations!
Welcome to another night of talks where living a happy life through the ways of God is our main course.
Last night, Ms. Kizaya Ramos discussed the basis of our spirituality. It was a very informative talk.
For tonight's topic, our speaker will share to us a life lesson, which is the restorer of our resiliency, and that is rest.
Magandang gabi sa inyong lahat, at magandang gabi rin po, Ma'am MJ.
Magandang gabi rin po, Sir James, at syempre sa ating manonood. Sir, napakasaya dahil alam natin na meron din pala tayong mga manonood galing Visayas at Mindanao, kaya gusto rin natin silang batiin sa gabing ito. Maayong gabi sa inyong tanan, mga kaigsoonan. We hope that you are enjoying our series.
Wow! Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat and welcome po sa ating series na Celebrations.
Kung bago pa lang po kayo sa ating series at may nakaligtaan na episode o nais panoorin, isearch lamang po ang ating official Facebook page, ang Nagaview Adventist College Media Ministries, at i-click lamang ang episodes na nais panoorin.
So before we proceed to our discussion, here's the question for tonight's episode. As a student or a worker, how is rest important to your life?
You are free to give your insights and ideas with regards to our question. At syempre, mamimili rin po kami ulit ng isang lucky viewer with the best answer at siya ang makakatanggap ng surprise gift. Our comment section is now open and don't forget to include your name and address. Thank you!
Let us focus our hearts and minds as we listen to a heavenly music that will be rendered by Chesca Caritativo. Huwag aalis dahil magbabalik ang Celebrations.
We pray for blessings, we pray for peace, comfort for family, protection while we sleep. We pray for healing, for prosperity, we pray for love is way too much to give us lesser things. 'Cause what if your blessings come through raindrops? What if your healing comes through tears? What if a thousand sleepless nights do what it takes to know you're near? What if trials of this life
through raindrops. What if your healing comes through tears?
According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, or CDC, getting adequate rest each night allows the body's blood pressure to regulate itself. Doing so can also reduce the chances of sleep-related conditions such as apnea and promote better overall heart health.
Getting enough sleep is essential for helping a person maintain optimal health and well-being. When it comes to their health, sleep is as vital as exercise and eating balanced diet.
Sir, paniguradong marami na naman tayong matututunan sa gabing ito.
Totoo, ma'am. Kaya nga, huwag na nating patagalin pa. Atin ang ipakilala ang ating tagapagsalita ngayong gabi.
Our speaker for this evening is a registered professional nurse. She is currently working at Moorings Arlington Heights as a restorative manager. She is also a graduate of Nagaview Adventist College, then Philippine Union College, Nagaview Campus, or PUC NVC, as a class president and batch valedictorian in 1981.
She migrated and got her nursing degree in Chicago, Illinois, USA. She believed that PUC NVC gave her the fundamentals to accomplish her success in life. She is no other than Mrs. Maria Luisa Ramos Perez. Let us now give her the time.
Hello, everyone. My topic today is about rest. It is an important part of creation health in order for us to experience complete health and wellness, physically, mentally, spiritually, and socially. Rest is a gift from God. When he himself rested on the seventh day. But before I continue, I'd like to share with you a short story that is from this book, Creation Health Discovery, written by Dr. Cummings and Monica Reed. The title of the story is The Nemo Syndrome. It is a fish story, and I'll read it from the book. Tony and Sonia Nicholson donated two beautiful aquariums to a local hospital. It completely changed the environment in the lobby. Instead of an unknown, unfriendly environment that intimidated children, it was immediately transformed to a place of delight. The brilliant clownfish, particularly attracted young kids. You could hear them squeal, "Look, Mommy, it's Nemo." But within a week, the fish began dying. Every few days, Nemo had to be replaced. The staff called in the aquarium expert, but they couldn't find the problem either. Finally, one of them said, "Are the lights on? Always on in this part of the hospital?" The answer was yes. "Maybe that's the problem," he replied. "They couldn't get any darkness for rest." So every night, the staff turned off the aquarium lights. And the result? Nemo lived. Brothers and sisters, an overstimulated world of pagers, cell phones, TVs, CDs, iPods could give you the Nemo syndrome. No time for proper rest could put you on an early grave. The solution? 7 hours of sleep at night. Quiet time with God in the morning. Pause at lunchtime to pray. And one day a week off to celebrate love. A weekly sabbatical to refresh your song. Today, we will talk about 7 areas. Number one, first, we will talk about the scientific support for rest. Second, getting out of the fast lane. We need to slow down. And number third that we will talk about, finding the balance between rest and activities. Number fourth topic, the rest zone. And number five, you deserve a sabbatical. And number six, discovering true rest. Dr. Kruger at the University of Kentucky found that the immune system actually triggers the type of sleep best for healing, called delta or slow wave. During this stage of sleep, the body releases growth hormone. It stimulates the growth and the repair of our damaged tissue. It also stimulates the white blood cells called lymphocytes to fight off diseases. What a timely topic to talk about, right? During our pandemic right now that we're facing. We have to listen to our body. When you start to feel tired, it may be your immune system signaling you the need for rest, for healing sleep. Secondly, getting out of the fast lane. Like I said, we need to slow down. We are on a very overstimulated society. According to the National Sleep Foundation, more than 40% of Americans, I don't know about Filipinos, sleep less than 6 hours a night. And stress is the number one cause of poor sleep. Third, finding the balance with each beat of our hearts teaches the importance of respecting the natural rhythm, the necessity to balance work and rest. During our lifetime, our heart will beat 2.5 billion times and will pump more than 1 million barrels of blood throughout our body. It is important to note that between each powerful beat of our heart, it rests. This resting period allows the heart to reload, to do the work of the next beat. Lub-dub, lub-dub. That's the sound of our heart. Likewise, my brothers and sisters in Christ, you and I need to reload. We need rest. God's healing rest is as close as the beating of your heart. He has placed the rhythm of rest within the very pulse of your own body by giving rest in each heartbeat, in each day, and in each week. Next is the rest zone. In our stress out world, our stress has become a major health problem. We desperately need the kind of rest that God offers us. Here is the famous invitation Jesus Christ made in Matthew 11:28. Come unto me, all you who labor to exhaustion, and I will give you rest. The book of Genesis tells us how God provided for us rest. It was an amazing week of work, and God knew it. God saw all that he had made, and it was very good. Genesis 1:31. And I continue to chapter 2. Thus the heavens and the earth were completed in all their vast array. By the seventh day, God had finished the work he had been doing. So on the seventh day, he rested from all his work. What was God doing here? Was he worn out from his work? Not likely. Instead, God was exemplifying and building a rhythm of rest into our weekly cycle. God was creating an island of rest in an ocean of labor. Lastly, discovering true rest. As I mentioned earlier, rest can come in many forms, through sleep, through relaxation, through meditation, through prayers, through worship, and even through relationships. And the true rest comes from Jesus Christ. In summary, here are 7 simple, practical steps to ensure our best success. Number 1, pray. Worry and anxiety often stand between us and real rest. When you have a rough day at work, tell God. While you're waiting in traffic, talk with God. Let him know your worries and cares. Then turn them over to him and trust that he will take care of you. The Bible tells us in Philippians 4:6-7, do not be anxious of anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, through which transcends all understanding, will guard your heart and minds in Jesus Christ. Second step on how to ensure rest is sleep. Develop a regular pattern, sleep pattern. Here's how to get those restful sleep. Number one, exercise daily. Reduce caffeine intake, especially late in the morning or late in the afternoon. Reduce alcohol, or eliminate probably. Avoid eating, excuse me, large fatty meals. Adapt an relaxing bedtime routine. Third step, breathe well. Proper breathing can help you relax. Number four step, imagine. Take a short mental vacation, maybe 20 seconds or more. By taking time away, you will resettle or resync your mind and be able to face your day with new energy. Five step, take an actual vacation. Studies show that our bodies need several days to unwind from the stress of everyday life. Well, you need a real vacation, that is, okay? A real one without iPhones, without computers, and other work. Just get away, play, and rest. Six steps is laugh. The book of Proverbs in the Bible tells us that cheerful heart is good medicine, but a crushed spirit dries up the bones. You see, when we laugh, our blood pressure goes down, our muscles relax, and our brain releases chemicals called endorphins that makes us feel better. So find whatever makes you laugh, then do it. Lastly, rest weekly. Never forget the special day, the Sabbath rest that God had created for us. When we leave behind our normal routine and spend one full day with God or with families or with friends, it's amazing how ready we are to tackle another week. Let's all rest our body, our mind, and our soul. Now go get some rest. Thank you. Let's bow our heads for prayer. Our Heavenly Father, thank you for the gift of life and this gift of rest. Help us live today in a way that brings glory to you, dear Lord. Throughout the Bible, we are reminded of God's direction over our lives. Thank you for your unfailing unfailing love, for your blessings and goodness. Thank you for your faithfulness to guide us and to see us through times of uncertainty. Thank you for taking away our fears and worries and reminding us that you are our strength, and it is only through you where we can find true rest. We pray that the beauty of our Lord Jesus Christ may be seen and reflected in us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Malu Ramos. Napaka-importante talaga na makapagpahinga tayo sa ating mga gawain sa araw-araw. Di ba, Ma'am Emmy Jane?
Yes, sir. Sabi nga ni Alan Cohen, there is virtue for work and there is virtue for rest. Use both and overlook neither. Let us always maintain the balance between these two things.
Yes, it is good to have a good amount of rest. But having too much rest is not a good thing anymore. Rest when you feel tired and when you needed to be re-energized.
Very well said, sir. Kaya naman sa ating mga manunood, let us always remember that rest is very vital to each one of us. And of course, just the right amount of rest.
Matthew 11:28 says, "Come unto me all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." This memory verse can testify that only in God we can feel and find rest.
Amen! Jesus doesn't ask us to work for the things this world expects us to. When we come to Him and focus on the things that matter to Him, we can find rest for our souls. While the circumstances of your life push you to your physical, emotional, or mental breaking point, Jesus offers us an easier yoke and we can find rest.
Thank you everyone for tuning in to our live stream and for sharing your insights. Don't forget to like and share our live stream. And we would like to thank Mrs. Malu Ramos for sharing us God's gift of rest.
And we would like to thank also our viewers from Naga and Legazpi for watching us this evening. Kita-kits tayo tomorrow for another Life Lessons from God through His chosen messengers. I'm Emmy Jane Patricia Brofas.
And Romy James Faliena.
And this is Celebrations!